Bienvenue dans l'entretien de
France 24. Welcome to the interview on France 24.
Aujourd'hui, on est avec
We have with us today Jean-Yves Le Drian, the French Minister for Europe and Foreign Affairs. He is visiting us here at France 24's offices at Bogota. Welcome.
Thank you.
I would like to start with the reasons for your trip. You are visiting two countries, Colombia and Cuba. Let's start with Colombia. We know that you have met with the Special Jurisdiction for Peace in Colombia, the organization taking over the transitional justice aspect of the peace agreement between FARC and the government. We know that you have met with the president-elect, the Minister for Foreign Affairs, amongst others. What would be, for you, the message that you would like to come out of this trip, given that the president-elect, Ivan Duque, announced that he would like to bring in modifications to the peace agreement, a peace agreement that garnered much support from France?
President Macron wanted me to salute the new president of Colombia before he takes up his office. I'm doing so with pleasure. He wanted me to come to Colombia, first of all, because there's the peace agreement. As you know, France has always supported the peace agreement, which for Colombia was a historic moment. First of all, domestically, to start living a pacified situation after 50 years of death, murder, aggression, conflicts, misunderstanding, violence. And it was also important for Colombia on the international scale because this peace agreement has given Colombia the strength, the reputation, and international prestige, which is renewed and which strengthens Colombia's position in Latin America, but also across the whole of the world. So I have come to talk about this with the new president and to say also that France continues to support this peace agreement because it is essential for, from our point of view, not only for the future of Colombia, but also for the fight against all these risks and threats which exist in other countries. And I think that with President Duque, we have understood each other very well. I don't have the feeling of a president who wanted to call into question these agreements. On the contrary, I had the feeling that on his part, he wants to implement a process of national reconciliation to make sure that these peace agreements not only settle the problems, that not only the history of Colombia, but its place in the world, and internally, domestically, to have a real national reconciliation process. The implementation of the Special Jurisdiction for Peace contributes to this process. I visited yesterday, and France will always support the stakeholders who want this peace agreement to be sustainable and enable Colombia to have a serene and peaceful future. This is what I told the president. The relationship between France and Colombia isn't linked only with the peace agreement. We have a strong relationship which was visible last year when we had an intercultural year between Colombia. More than 400 events were organized, cultural, scientific, sports events, and all of this has created links which we want to reinforce. First of all, by the number of French companies in Colombia, there are over 200 French companies present in Colombia. France is the first foreign employer of Colombian people in Colombia, and the prospects for the future are very good. And of course, the arrival of France 24 in Bogota is a very significant choice.
I would now like to talk about the other leg of your trip, Cuba. From what I understand, it's the first time for a French foreign affairs minister to visit, especially since the recent election of President Miguel Díaz-Canel. Why did you choose to visit Cuba?
It's a new event. There's a new president in Cuba, and President Macron wanted me also to pay him a visit because we have an important relationship between France and Cuba. We have contributed to the opening up, the gradual opening up of Cuba to the outside world. We have contributed also to the fact that there is an agreement for dialogue and cooperation between the European Union and Cuba. And I'm going there to show our determination to continue this process and to encourage the Cuban authorities to continue this movement. And they are now driven by a logic, a dynamic, which we want to strengthen strengthen. France is very present in Cuba.
There are investments in infrastructure.
Yes, in tourism, infrastructure, and also cultural exchanges, which are very significant. That's what I'm going to strengthen in our relationship. It's the first visit by a foreign minister of France to the new president, Mr. Díaz-Canel.
Nicaragua, the crisis in Nicaragua with President Ortega, who seems to have decided to quash the rebellion against him. There's the OAS recently passed a resolution. France is a founding member of the OAS. So what is the French government's position on what is happening in Nicaragua?
The drift is unbearable, unacceptable. France condemns the violence. France is asking President Ortega about his responsibilities. We have observed that 300 people have been killed recently during demonstrations which were repressed by the central government, which is unacceptable. So the positions of the Organization of American States on Nicaragua, we support. And we call for serenity to begin with and a stop to the repression initiated by the government and the resumption of a dialogue in order to arrive at a peaceful solution. We condemn the situation.
What about Venezuela, the other major crisis zone in Latin America?
Venezuela is absolutely dramatic. There's a political crisis which is unbearable, an authoritarian drift by President Maduro, with social and economic conditions that are such.
There are hundreds and thousands.
Hundreds of thousands of Venezuelans are leaving. The second worst migration crisis in the world, which we talk less about. We talk less about this than what is happening in Syria, and yet it's on a similar scale in terms of distress, separated families, people who are living with a very uncertain future, who are welcomed in neighboring countries. Colombia contributes a lot. Over a million Venezuelans have emigrated under pressure to Colombia because they can't live in their country anymore. So I'm not talking about the other countries. France has not recognized the elections that took place in Venezuela, nor has the EU. We believe there should be free elections under supervision, under international supervision, so that the people of Venezuela can express their views on their future. It's necessary to help Venezuela, which and Venezuelans who are being supported by the High Commission for Refugees are helping them. France will, in Colombia, will provide its support to the High Commission for Refugees of the UN. There are $500,000 will be allocated to help the action in favor of refugees in Colombia, where the largest number of Venezuelan refugees are located. This situation cannot last. President Maduro must realize that he's in an impasse, in a dead end, and he has historic responsibility for what is happening by sticking to this unbearable logic that has no future.
Let's talk about Mexico. There's a new president, Andrés Manuel López Obrador. It's quite a hard figure to come to grasps with. It's hard to predict what he's going to do. So what is your outlook on the new president?
It's an important moment in the history of Mexico. The arrival of Mr. Obrador is a historic turning point in the life of this country. So it's the decision of the Mexican people. France has with Mexico a very strong relationship, first of all, because Mexico is a great country, member of the G20, and we have a historic relationship with the Mexican authorities and with the Mexican people. We will continue this. I will be visiting Mexico very soon. We have established with that country what we call an alliance, which goes well beyond a mere partnership, and there's an economic dimension, but it also has a cultural, academic, scientific dimension, which we will continue, and we will have with President Obrador. This relationship will be strengthened. It's an important change. There are lots of changes going on in Latin America.
In fact, it's a historical change. That's what the Mexicans are calling it. Let's talk a bit about relations between France and Latin America, relations that go back far into the past, from the French Revolution with its values, the French Enlightenment. In fact, France has 24 embassies in Latin America, 250 Alliances Françaises, and roughly 40 French high schools, French lycées. And we're at a time where in Latin America we are caught between Trump isolationism on one hand and a rise in terms of trade and politics coming from China, which is quite considerable. So how do you see the role of France in the region? France with its friendly relations.
Yes, so there's a lot of sympathy. The ground is fertile. It has been accumulated for centuries with Latin America, and including the reference of the leaders, of the founders of independent Latin American states, their reference to the values of the Enlightenment and of France. These values still exist. And in the current context, where on an international level, we see a systematic dismantling of what has helped the world to live peacefully together since the end of the Second World War. And the world had agreed to regulate actions together. The world had agreed to give priority to dialogue, consultations, and confrontation limited to special places, not brutal trials of strength. And that is unfortunately coming to an end because of the American will to return to isolationism, power relationships, power block-to-block relationships. And this is a logic which is not that we defend, that the Europeans or France defend, nor is it the logic defended by the leaders in Latin America who have always been favorable to multilateralism, the construction of a rules-based management of the world, which is the result of exchanges and dialogue, confrontation and laws, a rules-based system. I'm thinking of the joint work we did with France and the EU in Latin America on climate change, which is a priority issue for the countries of Latin America. We want to continue to work on this, and I'm thinking also of the will to settle all our trade issues using adapted instruments and not through brutal trials of strength. This is creating a new dynamic, and the reason why I wanted to meet leaders of Colombia, Cuba, and soon Mexico, and soon President Macron will be visiting Argentina for the G20, and that is the objective which is supported by France and shared by the countries of Latin America. And beyond this, we must give our relationship with Latin America a logic, a dynamic which is not based only on the past, although it is important to refer to the past, but also based on academic cooperation, which is very strong. There are lots of Latin American students in France and a lot of French students in Latin America, scientific cooperation and the determination to invest in Latin America. France is one of the major investors in all Latin American countries.
So does that mean that the pro-Latin American drive started under the Hollande presidency is set to continue under the Macron presidency?
That is the logic that drives our policy, the will to reinforce this dynamic. Even though it's my first trip to this part of the world for 1 year, because there have been other major crises on the global stage that have prevented me from coming earlier. But the logic that we have is a very constructive and virtuous one.
Jean-Yves Le Drian, Minister for Europe and Foreign Affairs in France, thank you for your time and joining us here at France 24 in Bogota. Thank you for being with us. To you, our viewers, continue watching France 24 via our website, france24.com.